We just got news that Mac Miller's former drug dealer was arrested in connection with the death of Mac Miller for selling him some drugs that contained fentanyl. I am a recovering opioid addict, and I want to discuss this and discuss the pros and cons around these types of laws. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel, what I'm always trying to do is take different topics going on in the YouTube community or pop culture or just in the world and try to see what lessons we can learn from them to improve our own mental and emotional well-being. A couple things that I'm really passionate about are mental health and addiction recovery. So if you're into any of that stuff, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And do me a favor, YouTube, the algorithm does not like us talking about drugs, addiction, recovery, mental health, and things like that. So do me a favor, if you find any of the information in this video useful, please share it on social media, all right? Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Reddit, whatever your thing is, all right? I'm gonna be sharing some things and it might save some lives, all right? And by the way, while you're at it, follow me on social media, at The Rewired Soul, over on Instagram and Twitter. Feel free to DM me anytime if you have any questions or you need me to point you in the right direction for some help or some resources, all right? But yeah, it's been, I don't know, has been about a year since Mac Miller passed away from an overdose. So Mac Miller had his struggles with addiction, and I can definitely relate. He had some clean time. He ended up relapsing, and yeah, the drugs took him out. So those of you who don't know me, by the way, hi, I'm Chris. My clean date is June 23rd, 2012, so a few months ago, I just celebrated 7 years clean. My drug of choice was prescription opioids, so these types of subjects really hit close to home for me. So I'm also pursuing my CADC, which is a Certified Alcohol and Drug Counselor's licensing, and I've worked in addiction treatment for a little over 3 years, and I've worked with literally thousands of people struggling with addiction. And when I see this happening, you know, in the news, I feel like we need to talk about it, because yes, Mac Miller's drug dealer got arrested, and a lot of people are talking about it and like, yeah, awesome. But I wanna talk about some of the pros and cons behind this. So those of you who don't know what fentanyl is, like, the overdose rates for opioids, it's not getting any better, it's actually getting worse. And one of the main reasons is fentanyl. So you have like your standard prescription opioids with their potency and things like that, which you can overdose on, right? And then you have heroin. But then there's fentanyl, which is actually a prescription drug, and that is, I believe, 50 to 100 times more potent than heroin, okay? And what's been happening lately is that it's been being mixed with other drugs. Like, some people are pressing it with prescription drugs. Like, I believe it was Lil Peep who passed away. He was taking Xanax, and there was fentanyl mixed with the Xanax. This is happening more and more, but people are mixing it with heroin as well, and it's killing a lot of people. And I'll say this, as a recovering drug addict, and my drug of choice was prescription opioids, I'm really confused. And if you have any information on this, like, let me know down in the comments below, and no, I'm not trying to get you in trouble. But like, I'm confused as to why they would mix such a stronger drug. Because, and here's just, you know, me being an addict, right? Like, you have to pay more money for stronger drugs, right? And it doesn't make sense why dealers or even, you know, whoever's manufacturing this would mix this with other drugs. One, because you're like giving them more powerful drugs, but two, we know that it's killing people, and why would you want to have your clients die? You know what I mean? Like, it's just a really confusing scenario for me. But yeah, like, as a prescription drug addict, I used to get a lot of pills that weren't what they said they were. I would often have to like Google them and say, okay, is this what my dealer said they were selling me? But yeah, the government has been cracking down a lot on this, and we're trying to find solutions, right? Tens of thousands of people each year are dying from prescription drug overdoses. So they've been cracking down a lot on doctors, right? Because doctors and Big Pharma helped, you know, kind of fuel this opioid crisis that we're in, like with poor marketing tactics. You've been hearing about places like Purdue Pharma getting the crap sued out of them, and Johnson & Johnson just had to pay a huge settlement as well. A lot of doctors have been getting in trouble for overprescribing and everything like that. So they've been cracking down a lot, and one of the ways they've been cracking down is in some states or in some counties, they're making the dealer responsible for this. And they can be charged with, I don't know if it's murder or manslaughter, but like, is this a good thing or a bad thing? So something that we need to talk about is there are many dealers who are addicts themselves and they're not in a good place of mind. And like, I'm trying to think of, would I, like if I died, if I were to have died from some of my drugs, like would I want my dealer to go to jail, you know, for my murder, right? I think about that. And like the thing is, and it's different, but many addicts like myself, like we were suicidal, you know what I mean? And like I was gonna take anything. I was, you know, taking way more than I should have been taking. I was mixing it with alcohol and other drugs and everything like that. And you know, some of my dealers were addicts themselves, and some dealers are selling drugs in order to pay for their own addiction. And something that a lot of us are against is, you know, criminalizing people who are struggling with the disease of addiction when they should be getting help. So I look at this and I'm like, okay, like, but what if their dealer is an addict as well and they were just trying to fuel their habit and they didn't even know? So I'm hoping, you know, these are like case by case basis. So here's just my, purely my opinion. Like you have to analyze the situation and look at it. Like some dealers just don't give a damn, right? They do not care if you die, whatever, right? They're just scummy human beings. You know what I mean? But like I said, there's other dealers who are just trying to pay for their own habit. But here's one of my main concerns about this. In quite a few states, they've changed laws, and please, 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 this is why I asked you to share this video. There are laws that have been passed where if you call because your friend or someone you know is overdosing and you call, you cannot be charged with anything, right? Like they've passed laws to try to hopefully save some more lives, right? So when you have this amazing new law where you can call, say that your friend is overdosing and not get in any trouble for it, like that's a good thing. But if we're, you know, saying that you can be charged with the murder of somebody for supplying them the drugs, it makes it tricky because even though this law was passed where you can call in if somebody's overdosing, there's a lot of people still afraid to do so, right? Like, and that's one of the issues. Thousands of people each year are dying just because someone didn't call. Like, working in treatment, when I was working in treatment for 3 years, I had over 70 people die from overdoses. And in a lot of those cases, there were other people around or who knew. You know what I mean? So it's not necessarily this whole black and white thing. Like, I don't know, and I'd love to know your thoughts in the comments below on what you think about this. Like, when I look back at my addiction and my dealers, I had one dealer who was like, super shady, and like he's, if you don't know drug dealers, like this dude was like your typical drug dealer, all right? Like he's who you would expect. But most of my drug dealers, since my drug of choice was prescription drugs, a lot of my drug dealers were like old ladies, like no joke. And plus, like I ain't no gangbanger or anything, so I was like, okay, this is safe to get my drugs from old ladies, right? And some of them were just selling their pills to pay their bills and, you know, and things like that. And I'm like, would I want them arrested? And then sometimes I look at it like myself, like I would never classify myself as a drug dealer. Like, but I used to be the middleman a lot. Like I had a lot of friends who were using drugs too, but they didn't know where to get them. So they would give me money. I would charge them a little bit of a markup. So I would buy drugs from somebody else, get more drugs for myself, and then I would sell those to other people. Like, would I be responsible? You know what I mean? So these are just things that I think about, and I think we all need to think about them. And again, we have the elections coming up next year. Something that I haven't heard talked about much from anybody is the opioid crisis. We hear a little bit about mental health here and there, but we really need to talk about these things because The opioid crisis has been going on for years now, and it's not slowing down. It's killing tens of thousands of people. So the last thing I wanna talk about is Narcan, okay? Like, those of you who don't know what Narcan is, so like Mac Miller and many others die from opioid overdoses. And what happens is that drug, it attaches to certain receptors in the brain that can lead to the different symptoms of overdose, which can cause breathing issues, vomiting, choking on vomit, just all sorts of things, right? What Narcan does, it pretty much instantly reverses the effects of opioids, all right? It's in a few different forms. It's in, you know, some of it's a shot, some of it's like this like mechanical shot that go psh. There's another one, it's a nasal spray, all right, and it acts almost instantly. So a lot of EMTs have Narcan on them, right? A lot of firemen have Narcan on them. In some places, police officers even have Narcan on them. I want you to go out and research where you're from, because there are many places that are starting to sell Narcan over the counter, where you don't even need a prescription for it, all right? How much it costs, I'm not sure, but if you have a loved one in your life who is struggling with an opioid addiction, keep Narcan in the house, all right? There are also many organizations, like here in Las Vegas, I went to a free Narcan training and I got certified and everything like that, and the organization gave us free Narcan too. So research this in your area. Like, if you're living in an area where there's a major opioid problem, I almost guarantee there are places out there giving out free Narcan. But like I said, like, you might be able to save someone's life if you have an opioid addict in your life, all right? But anyways, yeah, let me know your thoughts down in the comments below about what you think about Mac Miller's drug dealer being arrested. And yeah, don't forget to share this video, because hopefully there's some information in here that might be able to help some people, and maybe we can get this conversation going, all right? And real quick, for those of you who are interested, down in the description, down in the pinned comment down below, I write books, ebooks, and I'll put a book down there. It's called Caught in the Crossfire. I wrote that for anybody who has a loved one struggling with addiction. There's different intervention strategies and everything like that, but it's mainly for you to keep your head on straight, whether or not the other person gets clean. It's only $3. I'll link that down in the description below. All right, but anyways, that's all I got for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And a huge, huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. You're all amazing. And a big thank you as well to everybody supporting the channel in other ways, like buying my books, buying merch, all that kind of stuff. It really helps out. All right, thanks again for watching. I'll see you next time.